We are here going to make... What are we doing, Malachi?
A model rocket.
Model rocket. Okay. So, I don't know if you guys knew this, but Hobby Lobby is not just for women. It is also for hobbies, right? And what did we get at Hobby Lobby?
Model rockets.
Okay. Show me the box. Show me the box. What do you got?
Model rocket.
Okay, what is on the model rocket? Show me.
The Amazon one and then the Crossfire.
Crossfire. And the Crossfire is made out of wood and a cardboard tube, which is pretty cool. But right now, we're going to work on this one, the Amazon one. Now, the Amazon can go up to 600 feet. That's actually pretty high with the C6. Yep, a C6-5 engine. And so we can get into that in a little bit. There's actually quite a lot of complexity that goes along with model rockets. So let's dive right
sometimes
in.
Sometimes there are two-stage ones, and then sometimes there are...
A single stage.
Yes. Yep. And then sometimes those big engine ones.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. And there's some rockets at Hobby Lobby that you can put an egg in it.
Yes, you can put in an egg or you can put in a little camera. These are just beginners because here's the thing. We'll go back to these rocket
engines. Well, no, this is intermediate.
Yes, intermediate.
And that's...
That's a beginner. The super shot. That's one C6-5, and this is a B6-4. We have been using B6-4s. That one's pushing us about 400 feet.
And also, we bought all of Hobby Lobby's.
We did. It's actually cheaper to go to Hobby Lobby.
Out of stock.
Yes. It's cheaper to go to Hobby Lobby.
They are out of stock of B6-4s.
And get all their B6-4 engines. So, each launch costs us about...
$2.
$2 and like 90 cents. Mm-hmm. So, it's actually... pretty inexpensive for a lot of fun, right? And building them is really fun. So let's get to building. Let's go ahead and take a look at the box. So this is two rockets.
And a launch pad.
And a launch pad.
But
all four.
Wadding paper.
$24.99. That is super inexpensive. Now, the thing is it does not come with any engines. It does not come with wadding paper or starters or anything like that. The plugs that you need to be able to put the engine in.
A bunch of wadding paper.
So what you can do at Hobby Lobby is you can buy a bunch of wadding paper. You can buy starters and plugs. When you buy the engines at Hobby Lobby, it comes with starters.
Plugs.
And the plugs as well. So it's pretty awesome. And that $2.90 cost per launch includes the wadding paper, starters, engines, etc. So anyway, let's get to it. We have all the pieces, the parachute. What is this called again, buddy?
Shock cord.
Shock cord. There are a few things required to build these model rockets. Scissors, yellow glue, plastic cement. So we have an Elmer's multi-purpose glue. And then we have super glue, which is going to be modeling cement. This doesn't allow you to squeeze it in the amount that you want to squeeze it in. So you can't control the squeeze. That's the only downfall. I bought the cheaper version just because I was like, all right, I've never done model rockets before. So anyway, I would prefer the squeezable, controllable kind. We purchased this from Hobby Lobby to be able to put
our things.
Yeah. Can you explain what's in there?
Engines, wadding paper, starter plugs, starters, and stuff.
What's that stuff? Your actual rocket. It's the Amazon rocket.
Just cardboard.
Okay. All right, are we ready? So let's go ahead and take a look at this. So if you look down here, this is the launch sequence right here.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, we have liftoff. Number two, we have acceleration. The thing goes off and goes, makes that noise, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's pretty cool. Then we have the climb phase. It just keeps climbing until we get the peak altitude. Once it hits peak altitude, the engine explodes in reverse on the opposite side. So it's not pushing down.
Because the smoke
it's pushing
is going
up.
And then the wadding paper comes out.
Correct.
And the wadding paper. The smoke. See it?
Correct. And see the smoke? And what that does is it pushes out the nose cone, which is not glued in. It's not in there permanently. It actually can come out. The nose cone, can you go ahead and take that off and show me? The nose cone actually comes off. So this one is not assembled. It does not have the shock cord installed or the parachute or anything. But when that nose cone comes off, the parachute gets exposed, right? The shock cord bungees away and then comes back. And then the parachute actually opens up right there. And it falls to the ground nicely.
And then landing.
And amazing. And you can just go catch it if you have a large enough field. So.
Or if you are fast enough, if you're a baseball player.
If you're a baseball player, that's correct. So here's the thing. We launched one of them, and we'll show you. We had to cut a hole in the top of the parachute.
So it falls faster.
Correct. Now, why do we want it to fall faster?
So it doesn't get stuck in the trees like last time.
Yeah, we'll show you right here. We have a video.
All right. We kind of got the rocket stuck, but you know what? Luckily, we have the Cybertruck. Yeah!
Woo!
And Pa brought his flagpole for flying.
Uh-huh.
If he didn't bring that, we would have lost... rocket.
Yeah.
So good job, Pa, and good job, Cybertruck.
Uh-huh.
All right.
But thanks to the Cybertruck,
we're... Thanks to Pa, too.
And Pa. Yep, Pa's great. Should we get to it? Let's build. Yeah. All right. Hello.
Hi.
Are you ready for this? All right, this is going to be super fun. We're going to go ahead and get started on our Amazon rocket from... So what we're going to go ahead and do is we're just going to get started. So we have the bodies, body tube, the shock cord, nose cone. You got your stickers, parachute, shock cord mount, correct? Mm-hmm. And then these are all the pieces right here. These are the plastic parts, okay? So what we have is the engine mount halves, the engine cap. We have the fins, right? That's going to help guide the rocket through the air. We have the tube coupler, right? Since we have two tubes, we need something to be able to put it together without
moving. We need two launch lugs.
Okay, and then we have a launch lug. We just have one. One launch lug.
Baby.
Why is it that we only have one launch lug? Because...
There's a launch lug
attached to the tube coupling. Body tubes. Okay. One, two. This is going to be a pretty tall one. How tall is this going to be when it's all said and done?
Hiccup tag.
Hiccup tag. Okay. What? How tall is this going to be? 29 inches tall. It's going to be pretty awesome. So we need two body tubes, which we came with. The nose cone, which this is a pretty cool long nose cone. That's pretty long. Don't point that in your eye hole. We need the shock cord mount, which is essentially, if you look here, the shock cord mount.
You could make a copy of it. If you want to.
Correct.
Or cut it out.
Or you can just cut your own out of a piece of paper and use that as well. Also attached to that shock cord is going to be this parachute, which this one's going to be a little bit heavier because it's bigger. We may not want to cut a hole in it. However,
because it might, if we do put a hole in it, it might fall too fast and then it'll cause impact to the body tube.
Number one, we are going to assemble the engine mount. Okay, this is going to require what kind of glue?
Super glue.
Okay, show me the engine mounts. Okay, we see the engine mount right here. A and B. So what we're going to do is we're going to take this. We are going to glue down the sides. So you can see the glue points that we need to do. It's all on these edges. See that? Or here and here. Not necessarily here, because that's where the fins go, right? So we're going to glue here, 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 and here. Are we ready? This super glue doesn't dry very fast until it makes contact. So what I'm going to do is we're going to go ahead and put this together. This is actually going to get glued into the cardboard. It also says remove excess cement from fin slots, hold until set, let dry. That is done. We're going to go ahead and take this and let this dry right here. Now, I would not recommend putting it on your family dining room table because you may get some glue on top of here. So,
hold it.
We're going to put it on a piece of paper right here.
Okay.
Okay. Number two, assemble the body tube. So
this should be super easy.
Would you like to do it for me? I need your body tubes, your coupling. Okay. Let's assemble it first to see and make sure it's good. Okay. What kind of glue is it telling us to use?
The same glue.
The same glue, which is?
Super glue.
You have the hiccups.
Yes.
I love you. Super glue. Okay.
I might drink some water.
Yeah. Okay. Oh. Tube down. Okay.
Coupling
so
down.
If you notice, it actually says to put the glue on the inside of the tube first, not on the actual coupling itself.
We glue like on the inside?
Correct. Yep. So can I show you how to do it real quick? So we're gonna run the glue just like this.
Oh, so the coupling touches it?
So the coupling touches it. This is the actual engine mount. Once the glue dries, it should be good. I'm gonna turn it a little bit and then let this dry, okay? So go ahead and show them. Go ahead. Thank you. Go ahead and show them how you're gonna glue this.
This?
Yep. Does it fit in there pretty snug?
That's a bug.
Snug as a bug, okay.
Ooh,
that one's really
snug. You
glue it just like I showed you.
Right now?
Yep.
I do the glue.
Yeah.
I'm scared.
Why? Go ahead.
I don't wanna mess up.
You'll be fine. Go ahead.
Do
you want me to do it? You can just do this one. Give me your hand. Come on. Grab it. You're fine. It's not gonna go anywhere.
I know.
It's not gonna bite you.
Okay. It's not an animal. It's not a
Kia. Okay, put it in there, tip it. See that? Don't squeeze too much. Push it in, okay? What's your favorite thing about rockets?
Seeing the
nose cone pop off?
Yes.
That's your favorite part? Where it pops off and and then you see the parachute and you're like, yes, it worked, right?
It's satisfying.
It is satisfying. So now we could actually join the two halves together. This is crucial though. When you put these together, what happens though, if we glue this and this launch lug is not aligned? Is that gonna work?
No.
You'll need an adult to help you with this to be able to make sure
it's good.
And as we can see, everything's glued in. Gluing that in now.
Hey, I think we should use the C65 because their engines are cheap.
The next step is install the shock cord. That one takes a little bit of effort because we got to cut out the paper.
Yes.
I'm going to take a piece of paper here.
Adult supervision.
Adult supervision, correct. And what I want to do is kind of trace out the shock cord mount.
Be careful.
All right, so here we are. This gets, like I said, glued on the inside of the rocket tube. You have to squeeze it together and glue it together.
Squeeze and glue.
Shock cord. Glue.
Glue.
As it's folded, the glue goes down on the center section. And this gets folded on top. It's about 30 minutes to dry, fully.
Yeah, which is not fast.
It's not super fast, but you know, we wouldn't want to launch this rocket yet.
Yeah.
You want this to dry fully.
Don't launch it in your house.
No bueno.
Unless you had a hole in your house.
It's true. You could launch it if you had a hole in your house. JK, I wouldn't.
I wouldn't.
That'd be crazy.
It'd
be smoky in here. Yeah.
Or you're launching fireworks in your house.
Basically, that's what they smell like, huh?
Basically, they are fireworks.
Yeah.
But...
So you can see where the wadding paper stops. Right on that X.
Oh, that's why.
See that? So now that we have this done here, this needs to get glued.
Because you can just wash it off really easily.
That's right. The next step is to glue it on the inside of the rocket. The problem is, I gotta let this dry, right? So what we're gonna do is I gotta let that dry for just about 10 minutes. Then I'll glue it. But what we're gonna glue on right now are the fins, okay? So we're gonna use this kind of glue, which is?
Super glue.
So if you notice, we're gonna do a dry fit again. If you notice, they actually just go in these little slots here. They go in and push forward. That's it,
Simple as that.
In, push forward. Looks like they get glued on this whole edge right here, the whole fin,
wow.
Yep. Push it down, in. That's it. That goes in there.
But that's pretty. That's super pretty.
I
wish y'all could see that.
You could.
Well, how?
Grab the phone.
Should I?
If you want. You guys want to see the sunset?
The audience says yes. Okay?
Audience says yes. Let's go.
No rain! We're back.
Put some glue here.
It's super pointy.
Ready? Yeah. Put it in.
My hand's shaky.
Yep, right there. That's it.
Shaky breaky.
Done. Right. That's pretty fun. I like building rockets with you.
We're not done.
We're not done. We got to prepare the recovery system, which is going to include the nose cone right here, but also shock cord. All right, let's go ahead and open it up. Okay, go ahead.
It's all folded ready. Just test it. Test it. Throw it.
I did. What's it going to fall to? It needs weight. Per the instructions,
this is the nose cone really close.
Rubber band has to get cut at an angle. I have an extra slot for this storage container that I'm going to just use as a backer, but it does require you to cut it at
an angle.
An angle. So you can see here, it's at an angle. This will get glued to the inside, way down inside. But here's the thing. You can't just glue it on the inside right here. What happens if you glue it just right on the edge? The nose cone will touch it and it won't fit. So it has to go down, as you can see, at least an inch lower on the inside. Right here, it is telling me to cut a hole inside of this outlet right here. So again, have an adult do this, and you can see it's just really lightweight. You can see that hole?
It's very lightweight.
And it's already done. Hole's cut. That's probably why you get that rubber band at an angle, don't you think?
Yes.
So you can grab that end and pull it through. So double knot.
Oh.
So how do we do that?
Knot two
one.
Times. That's one knot.
Two knots.
Two knots.
What I'm gonna do, according to the instructions, I'm gonna open this up, pull the parachute on through it. That's it, done. I'm gonna run some glue on the back side of this. I'll stick this on the inside.
Oh, you got a lot of glue.
A lot of glue. I'm gonna go in. You can kind of see I'm not putting my finger inside. I'm just setting it down below. I'll put my finger up underneath it and glue.
Bam.
I'm gonna take the weight off of it. You can actually see it on the inside. It is deep down inside there. All right, that's it. So now, guys, we let this dry. And we wait until we can get back and put this together and get it ready. We'll see you later.